So if you have to have a break from the gym for, say, more than 2 weeks, you can't expect to come back and run, row, cycle, and lift the same amount of weight that you were previous. It's just not going to happen. So you need to ease back into it over however many sessions you feel it's going to take. And for me, when we had COVID, the gym would close. I'd then be left to the kit that I've got at home, which isn't much. I'd be out on my bike every day. I'd do my core exercises. I'd go in the garage. I've got a multi-gym there. But even with that, it was just regular quality. I felt I couldn't really load it up. I felt any time it was going to break. But the object was just to keep my muscles sort of half fired up for when the gyms reopened. And then the gym would reopen. And it would still then take me 2 or 3 weeks to lift what I was lifting previous. So you've just got to listen to your body. So here we have me returning to the gym after 3 weeks away. I'll always start my workout with 30 minutes CV. I'll either do 100 steps a minute on the stair machine or 12 miles on the spin bike. But because it was cataract surgery, I thought I'd leave the stair climber alone for a month or so and just concentrate on the spinning bike. So here we are, day one. I covered 10.1 miles, and that's all I could do. Honestly, I think I say in the video it was a breeze, but that is all I could do. Day two was 10.7, and every day I'd just either increase the cadence or put a bit more gear on. To day seven was the first day that I managed the 12 miles. And I kind of had an inkling that that was going to happen, whereas years ago it would have taken me 2 or 3 weeks. I did a little personal challenge, 7-day challenge this time last year, May 22. And since then, and I go more into this in more detail in one of the lat pull down videos. Since that challenge, I've had so much more energy and managed to recover so much better than ever in the 25 years that I've been in the gym. And I'm absolutely clueless as to what really went on, but that's how it is, and I'm very thankful for it. It's funny because watching the videos of how I look between covering 10 miles and covering 12 miles. At 10 miles, I look sweaty and look like I've had a good workout. But the 12 miles, I look absolutely shot to bits. And then I look at the calorie difference between covering 10 and 12, and it's something like 108 calories, 1.5 chocolate biscuits. So I think to myself, just do 10 miles. Don't kill yourself. Just do 10 miles. But no, I've built up to this 12-mile distance, and I'm gonna keep going until, because I think I've said before, the day is gonna come. It's gonna come for all of us when we can't quite do our old program. And until that day arises, I'm gonna stick at it. And actually, what cemented that, I thought in my head, yeah, 108 calories doesn't sound a lot, but over a week, that's nearly 800 calories. I'm gonna stick at the 12 miles. So yeah, that's what I'll do.
They're going to be allowed to let go of their steering wheels for the first time. In the first European country.
First day back after 2 weeks off and had cataract surgery the day before my 55th birthday. Now I've got to have 2 weeks off. If you have to have a break, ease back into it over 3 or 4 sessions rather than have a risk of injury. I'll do the same in the weight area. do half sets, maybe 3-4 sets. Last two tracks to get me through this were Communication Breakdown by Led Zeppelin and Stay by David Bowie, 2001 live version. Great use of instruments on both those songs. Right, we'll go and see how we get on in the gym after a couple of weeks. Yeah, just to add to that, as you can see, I was covered just a little over 10 miles. So, 4 mile an hour. So, it felt nice, you know. I just feel, rather than push myself, you know, I am at 2 weeks off, your muscles aren't quite the same. I need waking up again, so kind of felt like a ride from the 1970s with my nan. But yeah, all good. Slightly better than yesterday, obviously. I just increased it by a knot. And I think if I just carry on doing that in the next 7 or 8 days, I should be back up to the 24 mile. All good. I wasn't going to go on the Stairmaster. Normally it's cycle, Stairmaster. But with it being cataracts, you know, bouncing along at 100 steps a minute for half an hour, don't really want to risk it. So I'll leave that alone probably for a month now and go back to alternating. It's May 2023, 7 days into getting back. Chipped away every day on here, as you can see, after 7 days, back up to the old level, 24 miles an hour, over half an hour, not shaking. Yeah, I felt really good. Today will probably be the first day I'll do my 4 sets. It's shoulders, back, triceps today. I'll try and get a video of that pull down. Tried a few times that people walk by, people come over and have a shower, which is lovely, but you don't want to see that. So yeah, fantastic, really chuffed with that. Sorry, but in this video I did say it was May. It's April, it's the 17th of April. There's my cataract date. So I had one on the 8th of March and one on the 21st of March. It does actually say August, doesn't it? Yeah, that's wrong. There you go, there's the follow-up dates. They suggested 2 weeks off. I've actually had almost 3 because pushing yourself as I do, pressure on your eyes, I thought I'll give it another week. So yeah, I came back on the 10th. It is now the 17th, as you can see on my television.